Academy. I just want to spend a moment giving you a little historic perspective. Karen and I started the dance specialization course over 12 years ago. So whether it's 12, 13, or 14, memory fails me, but certainly over 12 years ago. And I'm sorry Karen couldn't be here with me today. But the reason we started it is because we wanted to give dancers a strong foundation in the classical works of Pilates, although Bassi has a more contemporary approach to the classical works, but it's solidly grounded in the work of Joseph Pilates. So it's not what was happening is sometimes dancers, great movers, they were taking one or two, three, four exercises from Pilates, but they weren't studying Pilates. Karen and I both have a strong dance background and academic background and movement background. So we met each other many years ago, probably 23, 24 years ago, and we decided that we are going to give students a strong foundation in Pilates and layer on top of that strong foundation of Pilates dance specialization repertoire. And that's what was missing. What was missing is dancers were getting the specialization. It's like you all know that you cannot get your graduate degree before you've got your undergraduate degree. You can't get a master's or a PhD before you've done a bachelor's. It needs to build. So we wanted to give people that strong foundation in Pilates and then build on top of that a dance specialization program. So in all honesty, you are all so fortunate to get this wealth of information, particularly from Karen. Karen and I taught it together for the first few years, and then Karen has been teaching it alone. Such an amazing woman, amazing professional, professor at Cal State Long Beach, and you're getting all this Pilates information, dance specialization, and one thing I don't want you to forget is that you are part of the Bassi International family. It's an international family. Anywhere you want to go in the world, anywhere, let us know. We'll find a Bassi person that you can connect with. It's an incredible network of people that you can travel anywhere in the world, and you're part of a network of like-minded professionals. Okay? Any questions? No? You all look so great, so enthusiastic. So what I'm going to do, you know, Pilates is an amazing form of cross-training for dancers. And I'm using a term that is commonly used in the athletic community, cross-training. It's not until quite recently that we thought in terms of dance as cross, that we have a cross-training modality or regimen like Pilates, or even going to a gym or working with weights or whatever it may be. I think Pilates is amazing. Many dancers do. So what we're using Pilates for is cross-training to give dancers what they sometimes lack in. The dancers usually have incredible range of motion. I don't, but most do. So dance have incredible range of motion, but you need the strength to support that range of motion. And that is where often dancers are lacking, that balance between strength and mobility, not just having mobility. What do you do before a performance?
Warm up.
How do you warm up? Oh, good. What I remember is most dancers just stretching. They don't need to stretch anymore. Well, they need to, do some more exercises that are a combination of strength and flexibility. And so we're going to start with showing an exercise where you build a range of motion, but you need the strength to support that range of motion. Then we're going to go into a more dance-specific exercise where we can try and work on our arabesque, taking that range of motion that we just did in the full lunge, that stretch, and apply it to an arabesque. Then what we're going to do is what we call a full body integration exercise, where you need the strength of the upper body, a lot of strength of the core, or what we call in Pilates the powerhouse. We're going to add a little dance touch to that by adding an arabesque, and then we're going to finish with a beautiful back extension. And what often happens with back extension is dancers go into their comfort zone. We all love our comfort zone. A dancer's comfort zone in back extension is right in the lower back. Oh, I'm happy to be in that full extension. What we're going to do is focus on utilizing the entire back. All these intricate intervertebral muscles that go up and down the back. So we maximize the entire vertebral column and not just this small portion where we have excessive forces, shearing forces on the lower back. Okay? We're going to demonstrate all that online. So let's go. We've got it, four people. You can all casually sit around and watch. And if we need any assistance, we'll ask you to help. Okay, so we're going to start with the full lunge. Let's put it on a red spring in the middle on the third unit. You're all looking amazing. Let's get up on the carriage. So let's put our, we elected to put our right foot against the shoulder rest, heel pushing into the shoulder rest. Good, Melanie. Melanie, you could go a little higher. Lovely. Let's put our right foot on the ball, on the football, just opposite the hip. And we want the front knee to be above the ankle. So don't come too far forward with the knee. Let's take a balance in this position to test ourselves. Wow, Melanie, I love that self-cueing that you did there. Drawing the abdominals in, biasing towards a slight posterior tilt to the pelvis. Let's for today have the palms facing down like Antonella. I like it a lot, ladies. Beautiful support in that front foot. Let's put our hands down now on the bar and extend the knee of that left leg. Keeping the pelvis at the same height. And Antonella, go down onto the hand. Oh, yes. Use those back extensors. Come down onto the ball with your hands. Chin down a little. Remember, the head's an extension of the spine. I know you're thinking, when's he going to stop talking? But I will. Maddie, you're looking good. Perfect. Bend that front knee. Come all the way in. And let's put the foot down. We'll just do one on the other leg. Bring the carriage in, put the foot down. And Antonella, when you stretch out,
yes,
just watch that the pelvis doesn't drop.
Okay.
Keep it on that same level all the time. Okay. So it's a little too far in. We'll come up just slightly. I like that. I like that. I like that a lot. Let's take our balance. Lower this heel just, oh yes. Don't rely too much on that foot. Maybe lift the chest a little further away from your thigh. Good. And lift your arms a little, Maddie. Maddie, arms facing the door. And put the foot, the hands down. And pelvis goes along the same line. Oh, so much better. Head down a little. Palms down. Flatten the back. Melanie went a little too low. And Melanie, you came up a little too high. Flatten that back just a little more, Melanie. Right there. Use those back extensors. And bias towards an anterior tilt to the pelvis. So you want to use those back extensors. Use those back extensors. Antonella, I love where the way you're thinking. I can read your mind from here. And bend that front leg. Bring the carriage in so there's no clunking, and then put it down. Slowly put the foot down. We'll just do one on each side. Mm-hmm. Now we're going to apply that incredible flexibility and strength that you've got into a real exercise, into a real dance move. Let's do the arabesque, going into the arabesque. So what spring? We're going to use a yellow spring. Good. So this is one of Karen's great exercises, not this one. It's not a sin, but it's just will change the exercise. I'll help you here in a minute. Okay, so let's kneel on the carriage. We'll do one on each side so we're nice and balanced. We're going to do our right leg first. So if you could just help, we've got frames that are going to help you put it in. Okay, so we'll start in parallel, and as we gain height, we'll externally rotate the hip joint. Start with just a little bit, take the slack out of that strap, and now go into your maximal arabesque before bending the arms. Maddie, let's start that again. So let's get the maximum, and then add the arms to it. Now we're going to go into an attitude, increase the extension, and then straighten that knee. Wow, you're looking amazing. And so now I'm just going to take you back to center. Okay. You came over the center. Okay. So just watching your endeavor. Okay, let's straighten up the arms. And just relax for a moment. So what happened is as you opened your pelvis, the leg went too far open. Okay. Just don't overdo that, the opening of the pelvis and taking the leg up. Let's do one more, and then we'll go to the other side. Okay, straighten out the leg. And lifting. And then going into your punche. That's where you started drifting. Now go into your attitude. There. Increase the extension. Beautiful. Now up to the ceiling. And then slowly lower it down. Wow. Other side. Feel it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. So as you can see, we've taken Pilates, dance, made a very dance-specialized movement, one of Karen's signature movements. I love it. Straightening out. One second. Lovely. Okay. From there, lifting the leg, going to your external rotation. Now, bend the elbows, go into your punche first. Maddie, you've got straight knee still, straight knee. Now, into your attitude. Increase the extension, and then stretch up. Straighten that knee, and take it down. And Tanella, again, you're going over the midline. So I would rather you compromise a little on height, but not on alignment. Okay. So you're just going... You know what? Think of it as keeping your shoulders very square. The moment you lift that left shoulder, the leg has a chance of going. So rather think of anchoring, having that straight line in the shoulders, and that'll give you better alignment. Let's do one more for Maddie. Not for Maddie, sorry, Maddie. But it's for you as well. And taking the leg up. Keeping the shoulder down. There. Going over the midline. And bend the knee. Increase. increase the extension in the hip joint, and then straighten up to the ceiling. Come back towards me a little, Antonella, with the leg. And then slowly down. Okay, let's put the bar back up. And preparing for balance control feet. Okay. I would suggest the third gear is the furthest away. The first gear is, it'll give you a bit more support. Okay. Stand on the carriage. Putting your hands on the shoulder rest. Put your right foot on the bar. Football. Straighten that right leg all the way and plantar flex the foot. Now you're already in the middle of the exercise here. Now try to bring the carriage further back so the shoulders are above the hands. Without the carriage moving, slowly take that other leg onto the... Nice. A little more extension in the back. There. But don't lift the head. Your head is good. Good. Now, reach the arms forward and bring them back under the shoulders. And forward, bring them back under the shoulders. Stay there. Lifting the right leg into a small extension. Keeping the pelvis still. I love that you all kept your pelvis still. Reaching the arms forward. And back, and forward, and back. Put the leg down, point the feet. Extend this back a little, too much for you?
No.
Okay, good. Take the other leg up, and reach forward, and back. And overdo the internal rotation of the shoulder, there. And forward. And back, put both feet on.
Oh, sorry.
That's fine. Put one leg down, one foot down, Maddie. Bring the carriage into the stopper. And put the other foot down. Good. So when I support you, I'm really offering you support. There's no problem. If you would have fallen, I would have been holding you. Right? As a teacher, you need to know that if you give someone the sense that you're spotting them, you need to be in the worst case scenario in your head. I knew if Antonella had to drop into my arms, I was really, really bracing for it. Okay? Let's do the last exercise. We always love finishing with a beautiful back extension. Every dancer loves back extension. Put the boxes on the carriage. I would suggest a blue spring, or even, I don't mind how heavy it is, it can even be a yellow. Let's do a blue on the first gear, and that's going to be very nice. Now remember that spinal articulation, that reverse spinal articulation, so we're so used to the pelvic curl where we're going into flexion, but here we're doing extension, it's still that same spinal articulation reaching out from the tip of the head as you stretch the arms, reach that height. Then hold it or increase it slightly as though take the arms back. But I want you to think as much of that concept of elongation as height. I really want you to think of those upper backs working, not just the lower backs. Let's go. And holding on there, lying on the box. Try and get a little external rotation in the shoulders. And inhale as you reach out and up, taking the arms around all the way to the sides. And then exhale as you come in and drop down to horizontal. And inhale as you reach out, take them around. And horizontal, and come down. shoulders a little. As you reach out, then the strap won't get stuck on your elbows. So internally rotate a little. And inhale as you reach out. A little more internal rotation, and then you won't get stuck there. And then take the arms all the way around. And down. Very nice, Antonella. Just lower those legs a little. Don't rely so much on your hip extensors. The legs are stable. They're like an anchor. And last one, inhale. And take them around. And exhale as you go down. Good. Slowly get off to bring the carriage in. Put the straps back and give yourself a little reward by getting into the rest position on the box with the arms reaching over the bar. So rest position, arms just relaxed. Yes, stretching out those backs after that intense work. Slowly come up to a sitting position, roll up. Okay, well, you ladies were amazing. You're all amazing out there. You're all amazing. And good luck in your continued journey in the Bassi Dance Specialization Program. Come visit us at the Academy. And thank you all very much. Thank you. Thank you. What a rare privilege to get to know you all. Okay, thank you guys.
Thank you very much. 6,000 views.
Wow, you're kidding. That's amazing.